Hello dear students, we have welcomed to your mathematics class. Today we are going to start on with your topic division, as you all have done addition, subtraction and multiplication also. Today we are going to start division, that is like single digit number you have already done. Now we are going to move on with a large number, that is it will be 4 digit and 5 digits also, but it will be with 2 digit number. That first we are moving on, that how we will be doing the division and what is division, that is basically important, we need to know. Let's see what is division. See, what is division? Division is called as repeated subtraction. Division is repeated subtraction. As you have learned, what is multiplication? Multiplication is repeated addition. Similarly, here what are we learning? Division is repeated subtraction. See how repeated subtraction, that also we should know. How? See, a small number, I am going to take it out and you will understand by that how it is repeated subtraction. Let's see, 24 divided by 12. 24 divided by a small digit number, it will be very easy for you to understand. See, 24, then how it will be with the repeated subtraction, that we are going to learn first. See, this is division and this is by repeated subtraction. Both the ways I am going to show you. 12 twos are, I know the table of 12, yes, 12 twos are 24. Okay. So what answer I have got here? That is 2. So let's see, I got 2, but how it is with the help of repeated subtraction, that also I should know. See, 24 divided by 12, it means I am going to divide it like done it is by 12, but how I am going to do it? Help of subtraction, that also I should know. Yes, minus 12, see, 2, 1, I have got 12. See how it is going to be now. Is it 0? No. See, I have to subtract it till I get 0. Till I get 0. Yes. So again I have to subtract 12 only. See what I have got? I have got here 0. Now my step is complete. But now you count how many steps it was. This was my first step. Okay, this was my second step. Means in how many steps I have done? I have done this in 2 steps. See, once I have subtracted, again I have subtracted. It means what is my answer? 2. So twice I have done that. So it means this is the way we call it as it is repeated subtraction. This you have done in 3rd standard as well as in 4th standard also. Okay. So I hope this part is clear to you, how it is the meaning, this is repeated subtraction. Okay, let's move on with sums, which is like a 4-digit number I can say, or I can say it as a 5-digit number. Let me, like in your exercise children, like you will be having 4-digit as well as your 5-digit numbers divided by a 2-digit number. See, in your starting page, that is 124, it is a simple exercise which is a 4-digit number divided by very simple 2-digit numbers, like divided by 20, divided by 30, divided by 50, divided by 60. So this you will be doing it in your book only. So this is just a recap what you did in 4th standard. Okay, so now we are moving on with how we will be dividing it with a 2-digit number, that is, and what all these numbers are called, that also you should know. So let me take an example from your book only, that is 8670 by 15. Okay, 8670 divided by 50. I hope all are revising the tables as you are doing the multiplication also. I hope that video also you have gone through, and that calculation whatever was there, the exercise whatever you would have started it, and I hope that is completed also. So for that also you are revising the table. Children, see, basically tables are very very important for multiplication as well as division. So please revise your tables every day one by one. That you should start on from 2, 3. So take it as 3, 4, 5. Okay, today I am going to do 2 to 5. Next day you take on like this, you need to revise the tables. Okay, so for this now I need to know the table of 15. So see, I know many of you know the table of 15, but still many of you will have a doubt of 15's table, children. But as we are now in 5th standard, so we should be thorough with the tables, at least till 20 we should be thorough with that tables, okay. So like 15 tables, okay, if you still have a doubt, you can make a rough column here, you can write down the table of 15. But I hope that is clear that what is the table of 15, and I hope that you know the table of 15. Okay, let's move on. How we will be dividing that, firstly we will come to know. Okay, what is 15 ones up? That is 15. Yes. What is 15 twos up? 15 twos up 30. 15 threes up 45. Yes. 15 fours up 60. Yes. Then what is our next number? 15 fives are. Next is 75. Okay, let me see which can be particular a number which I need here. I have already written, so it will be a help for you. So revising, even if you know the table, in the rough column you can write down the table, that is going to help you out. Okay, so let me write down this number very clearly. 8670 divided by 15. Yes. Now see, children, what we have to do, this we know, we have done in 4th standard also. I need to see, like, can I take a single digit number? No, because this is a 2 digit number. This is 15 here and this is 86. Means what we have learned, we should always have a number equal to this, or we will take a number lesser than this. We will not take number greater than that. Then how we will subtract? Not possible, isn't it? So let us see how. So see, children, 2s are, 3s are, 4s are. I will not take 4s are because here we have 75 less than this. Now, but what is 15 6s are also I can see? What is 15 6s are? Yes, 15 6s are is 90. Yes. Now see, I have got 86 here, but here is 90. So am I going to take 90? No. What am I going to take? I am going to take number less than this, that is 70. 5. Yes, 5 is a 75. Okay, now what is our next step? To subtract. 6 minus 5 is 1. 8 minus 7 is again a 1. So now see, I have got 11. But see, what is the next step what we have done in this? Yes, we have to bring the another digit, that is the 7, down. Yes. 7. Now what is our number C? 117, that is 117. Now I will see, I have done till 15 6s. Now I will jump on to 15 7s. Yes, what is 15 7s, children? It is 105. Yes, it is 105. Now what will be 15 8s? What it will be? Yes, let us see what is 15 8s are. 15 8s are is 120. What is 15 8s are? 120. What is our number here? 117. And what is here? 120. So we are not supposed to take that because that is a larger number. No, it means what are we going to take? We are going to take 105 here now. Yes, so what it is? 15 7s. So here I am going to write 7s. Yes. Now, what am I going to write here? I am going to subtract here. 2, 1, and this was 1, children, so it is 0. So what is the leftover here? 1, 2, that is 12. Now anything is left out? Yes, still our 0 is left out. So I am going to bring the 0 down. So now what is our number? That is 120. So what is the next? Yes, I am having this. 15 8s are 120. So yes, 8 will come here and I am going to write 120. So see, can you see anything left out here? No, children. All these numbers are 0. It means I am going to be like, see, here only my number left out is 0, 0, 0. It means I don't have a remainder here. The remainder is 0 here. What is the remainder here, children? It's 0. Okay. So now we have learned how to divide a 4-digit number with a 2-digit number. Okay. Out of these, I should know what are these called. Okay. So with this, I will take another number which will have a remainder so that you will come to know that how it is going to be. That if I am taking a remainder, how will I check the answer? That will also I know. So out of this, I suppose you have understood how to divide a 4-digit number with a 2-digit number. Now I'll be taking a number which will have remainder also. There I'll tell you which is called divisor, which is called dividend, and which is called remainder. Okay, so let us move on and let us take another number, that is, let me take it out, 39912 divided by 64. That is a question from your book only I am taking, children. So it will be easy for you even to refer also. So I hope this was clear to you. Okay, now let us move on with another number, that's a 5-digit number. Okay, 39912, that is divided by a large number, a 2-digit number, that is 64. Okay, so now let's see. See, now you'll be thinking 15 table was too easy for me. But how am I going to do 64? Is it easily possible to learn the 64 table? Children, little difficult. See, everybody won't be able to learn with by heart these all tables. See, till 20 you should be very thorough. But the easiest way is writing down and calculating it in your rough columns. That will be going to be very, very easy for you. Let us see how. So now let me write it down here. Divided by 64. Now how it is to be with 64, that is, I will be writing down here. I know 64 ones are 64. 64 twos are. So what am I going to do is, I am going to calculate here as multiplication. Yes, it is 128. What is 64 threes are? Okay, my next step. 64 threes are. 3 fours are 12. Carry over 1. 6 threes are 18. 192. So like this, you will be writing it down in your rough columns. It is going to be very easy for you for the calculation. Now next, 4s are. How it is going to be? 4s are. Now let's see. 4 4s are 16. 6 4s are 24. Plus 1 is 25. Now till 4 I have done, children, and I'll be having, see, I can create a space here and even I can write it down. As you have a large left column, you can write it down there also. 64 5s are. Yes, 5 4s are 20. 2 carry over, 5 6 are 30, plus 2 is your 32, so it is 320. Now next is 64 6 are, 6 4 are 24, 6 6 are 36, plus 2 38. So till here I have calculated. Now let me see what is the number am I going to take. See, here it is 64. So is it possible for me to take 39? No, not at all, because 39 is a smaller number than 64. So what am I going to take is 399, that is 399. Now let me match on with what number I should take. See, here all are 192, 256, 320, then again 384. It means if 7s I am going to take, it will be definitely a larger number. Okay, so let me calculate it now for 6a. Yes, 6a is 384. 5 here, 9 minus 8, 1, 3 minus 3, 0. Okay, I have got 15. What is my next step? I know, yes, I have to bring this one down. So now I have got 151. 151. Now let us see where is 150. Is it visible? No. Here it is 128, here it is 192, and here it is 256. It means I need to take less than this, that is 2za. 2za is 128. Yes. Now let's see how to subtract. 11 minus 8, because 8 is not subtracted from 1, so I'll be taking it as 11. 11 minus 8, what will be the answer here? Yes, 3. Now here what is left? 4. 4 minus 2 is 2. Here it is 0. Now anything left out? Yes, here I have 2. So I'm going to bring this 2 down. See, 232 is left. Is it over? No. I have 64 here. I have 232 here. So it is not possible. Like, I'll be not leaving it here because here it's a 3-digit number and here it's a 2-digit. Again, I'll be calculating. But let me see which number I should take. No, not possible. Is it possible? No, not possible. It means now 192 is possible, children. So, children, like next time I'm going to take it here as the space is less. So, it will be very difficult. As you will be doing, you will be having a full page. You have to cover it on the full sums in one page only. Okay. So, let's see. I'm writing again this 232 here. So, it will be easy for you to understand. Okay. Let me take this. Threesa, I'll write it here. And what am I going to write it? 192. So, this has gone here, children. Yes, 2 minus 2, 0. Now, what is here? 13 minus 9. What will be 13 minus 9? So, first you will be, just please don't write. There's no need to write as we do normally the addition and subtraction. Whenever you are writing on the top. But here you won't be writing. So, you have to just subtract what is 13 minus 9. So, what is 13 minus 9? So, see, you'll be counting that how the subtraction was very clear for you. I suppose that was very easy. So, 13 minus 9, always keep that 13. Okay, 3 is done. Then the next one is... See, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So, I mean, I know that my 4 is left here. Yes, 10, 11, 12, 13. Then it is 1 minus 1, 0. So, what is left now? 40 is left here. Now, here what is there? 64. It means my number, what am I going to take is it smaller? Yes, I have now got the smaller number. 40 is smaller than 64. So, is it possible for you to divide now further? No, not at all. So, what are we now going to call it as? That you should learn it now. Now, this is called as, answer in division is called as quotient. Answer in division is called as quotient. Answer in your division is called as quotient. Okay, so like this, how you will be doing it? The next one is your dividend, that is, and this is your divisor. Okay, so this was quotient, this was dividend, and this was divisor. This was all about your division, that how you will be dividing the numbers with a smaller number, with a larger number. So this all we have done it. And the next class, children, will be learning how to check the numbers and how to divide it with 10, 100 and 1000. So I hope this was all clear. Okay. So thank you. We'll meet in the next class and we'll confirm. Okay. Thank you. Thank you.